I've been so many places, I've seen so many things, but none.
Jennifer.
My sister! Hey. All right. So happy.
My ride or die, Angie and Rod, they are amazing. Really good friends that walk with us through the journey of raising kids. And I remember when I first started the program, I was going home at 10:30 at night, and I called her. I said, "Are you still up?" And she said, "Yeah." I said, "You know what? This don't make no sense. I'm all self out at 10:30 at night, leaving school. I should have did like what you did. I should have got my education when I was young. But no. I'm going to go do something else." I said, "How dumb was that? Now it's late. I'm getting home in the middle of the night." And I laughed and laughed. And many times when I would call her on my way to school, it would be school starts at 6. I would be calling her like 6:15. "So are you at school yet?" "No." "So I don't think you went to school one day on time." And I said, "I'm important. I'm busy. I can't get there on time." So we would laugh about that, because every class on Monday night, I would always be late. But I would get there just at the cutoff. But I want to thank you, sis. Thank you for your friendship and your encouragement and just riding with us on this journey. All of you, thank you so much for coming today and just being the very best part of life, and the very best part of what God is doing in our life is because of each one of you that's here. And thank you so much. You are all gifts to us, and you all inspire us every day to just keep going and keep trusting God and keep following Him. You make the journey worth living and traveling with God. So I love you, and y'all gotta eat some more food.
I just wanna say congratulations, Sister Wilson. You go, girl, because you did that. You did. And I know it wasn't easy. It was hard. There were times when I saw you, I could see that look on your face. You were so tired and weary. But you kept right on going, because you operated in the strength of God. And Pastor Wilson was behind you every step.
Amen.
You guys traveled all over the world. And look at you now.
I want you to keep on.
I can remember there were times in my life when I was going through some things, and I called Sister Wilson.
Yeah.
She took the time out of whatever she had to do to come and talk with me and pray with me. I'll never forget that.
Yes.
And Pastor Wilson, you and Sister Wilson are such an inspiration to me. I've been a member of the church for 4 years.
Yes, ma'am.
New Beginnings is the best church in Fresno.
Show no.
Believe that.
Show no.
I love you both. Show no. Congratulations.
Love you, Mom.
I see we all talking and sharing about my sister. Well, first of all, everyone has said congratulations. I'm so very proud of you. I'm talking about we go way back. And I'm so thankful for what God has done in your life. I want to commend your husband for being a promoter of education and starting in your home. You do it for so many other people, but you didn't leave your home. And the way you were life's cheerleader, I commend you. Thank you for allowing us to come alongside and pray you through this journey, laugh with you through this journey. I remember dropping you off at school, talking about all the times that you started. I remember taking you to school in Alabama. And so, when we visited out there and stuff, and it was good. And so I'm so proud. When I saw you today, I just thought what heaven would say. Heaven is proud.
Yes.
Heaven is proud. And you just keep up the good work. I can't wait to see what God is going to do in your life. It's been wonderful. Thank you for being my sister. Thank you for being my friend. Thank you for being my road dog. Thank you for being my international travel partner. Thank you. Thank you for knowing my secrets and still loving me as your friend and not looking at me any way crazy. Thank you for letting me be myself. I love you and I'm so proud of you. So, bachelors, you know I don't want to go back to get my bachelor.
Go together.
And I know where you are, but we may just have to do this thing together.
That's so, right.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Way back. Too far. Oh, my gosh. So long.
Give me
ago.
An E.
I can remember her coming to my house and my mom. Talking to her because of her beauty and telling her, pretty girl, get reputations, don't be one of them. And just sharing things with her. And Trina and I developed a friendship. Darlene, oh my God, my girl Darlene. We just go so far back. And I mean, we graduated high school, and to see you doing this.
Things never looked clearer.
I'm so proud of you, sis. When I came to Mosqueda Center one day, I heard about this church. I didn't hear about the pastor. Who the pastor was, it's just this church at Mosqueda Center. And walked in there and seen Darlene say, my friend here. And then Sharon saw me, that's my friend. I'm like, oh my God, it's you guys. But it's been so wonderful. You guys have been such a blessing. Such a blessing. And to see what God has done with you. If anybody thinks God is my greatest, inspiration. I love you. Congratulations.
Powerful.
I plan to give you all that I have.
So approachable.
I'll be everything.
So transparent.
Everything you think I am.
I'm so proud of you and what you
make life.
Just
a joy to live. And I'm thankful.
Yes, you can see each other. Sometimes it won't go. It's once a month, but boy, when we do, that friendship. And I think you are a friend that I don't. I have a lot of Christian women in my life, but you are special because you speak real godly wisdom, and I'm so grateful to have you as a friend. And I love. At these times when I get to be a part of your church family and others who are so important to you. So, love you. So grateful.
And you're still beating odds, so glad that you made it. Glad that you're a graduate. You know, now you get to go on your graduate vacation, hopefully.
You inspire me.
See how I threw you a lob there, now you just... Maybe a trip to Cancun wouldn't be too bad. Send me and the boys out to Vegas or something. No, I'm just kidding. I just want to say you worked hard. I know, like almost every other night you were in the office, just grinding away, trying to push through all your homework. You were up super late. You had late classes. The nights that you didn't have late classes, you were making sure the food was steady, and more than steady, it was bomb. And the house was clean, and you never showed any complaints, you never showed that you didn't want to do it, you just kept your head up, and you just kept grinding through. So now that you had a lot more free time on your hands, you need some more money. No, but I'm glad that you did it. Now it's me. So finish this race for us strong, you know?
You inspire me. Don't you know I love you, girl?
Yeah.
know what you do to me. Come on, keep on lifting me
higher.
Higher.